Welcome back to our Rivage PM training series. I'm Andy Cooper from Yamaha's research and development team based in the UK. Now, I'm going to present a series of videos about scene memories, how to manage and automate them to produce a successful show. As digital mixers have grown in power and facilities, scene memories have become more important to manage the behaviour and setup of thousands upon thousands of parameters. From input patching through channel names to EQ and dynamics parameters, effects and plugin assignments, and of course, fader levels, mix send levels, and mutes. But that's not all. How these parameters change from act to act, or song to song, or even multiple times within each song, can be determined by all the functions associated with scene memories. So, we shall begin with the basics in this video, and look at more advanced facilities in the next few videos. Firstly, let's understand, when we store a scene, what parameters actually get memorized? We shall start with the obvious and most visual. All channel faders and on keys, including DCAs. Also, all head amp settings, that is input gains, EQ and dynamics parameters. All plug-in settings, including graphic EQs and the Dugan auto mixers. Pan and balance settings, insert and direct out settings, all mix send and matrix sends, mute group assignments, channel pair settings and bus setup, whether surround mode is selected or not, or whether a bus is fixed or vary or mix minus. That's pretty much all the features that affect the sound of audio passing through the mixer. And all input and output port settings is included, along with channel names and colors. So, what isn't included in a scene memory? That would be system config functions like twin lane assignments, Dante setup, port-to-port patching, and MIDI and GPI assignments. Also, user setup functions such as custom fader banks, user-defined keys, and preferences are not included. They have their own user setup library instead. Then, all the parameters in the monitor menu, including Q, oscillator, talkback, and metering points, are also excluded from scene memories. And finally, the on-off status of mute groups is not included in a scene memory. So, certain channels can be kept muted during a scene recall. However, the assignment of channels into a mute group is stored and recalled. It's all pretty logical, really. They are the functions that you want to keep the same throughout a performance, and they can always be backed up to a USB memory and loaded into other consoles for future events. Now, back to the scene memory menu and how it's organized. The scene field is always visible in the menu bar just below the meters on the screen. This normally shows the current scene or may show the next one to be recalled. It will also indicate with a yellow E if any scene parameter has been edited since it was last recalled or stored. Touch this area to see the scene list screen. Here you can scroll through all the scene memories that are stored in the console. You can view the list in various orders: numerical order, ascending or descending, or alphabetical order, or chronological order, oldest first or newest first. The current active scene is always highlighted with a larger number. To quickly return the list to the current scene, press this double arrow button. If the link to surface option is selected, then the ink and deck keys on the surface will also scroll through the scene list. Press and hold either to scroll quickly. Press both together to return to the current scene. Scene store, recall, and update can all be operated from the keys on the surface. Use store to create a new scene and use update to overwrite the existing scene with the current parameters. Both store and update will always memorize all scene parameters. You cannot create any kind of partial scene. Of course, there are separate libraries for individual channels, plugins, and other processes. However, the scene recall operation can be filtered in several ways to allow only a few parameters to be adjusted rather than the complete mix. We'll talk about these features, including focus, recall safe, and isolate, in another video soon. For now, let's talk about scene numbering. Rivage PM systems can memorize 1,000 scene memories, and they can be numbered quite flexibly. For every main scene number, you can have up to 99 sub-scenes. This is just to help your organizing. There's no difference in functionality between a main scene and a sub-scene. So, you could create a main scene for each song in a show, then add sub-scenes as you program different settings for different parts of the song, such as a chorus or solo section. The good thing about sub-scenes is that you can insert them without altering the numbering of the subsequent scene memories. To quickly create a new sub-scene, hold Shift while pressing Store. It will suggest a suitable sub-number, allowing space for more scenes to be inserted before and after it, though you can edit the number before you store if you prefer. Hold Shift and Ink or Deck as a shortcut. If you want to change a scene's number or title later, you can edit it in the scene list. Just touch the number or title. The same applies to the comment field. This is for you to write an additional note or reminder, any regular text or numbers. The comment can be seen in the menu bar by holding Shift and touching the scene field. Here there are delete and duplicate functions for managing the scene list. Duplicate can be useful for creating a backup scene before starting to edit. There's one undo for the previous operation, in case of a mistake, so take care before proceeding too quickly. Users of previous Yamaha consoles will be familiar with the concept of scene zero, where there was always a blank scene with all the parameters at their default position. Rivage PM systems don't include a scene zero, but they do have a useful clear mix data option. This will return all mixing parameters to their default position, but will keep the channel names and patch settings. This is particularly useful in a fixed installation where the channel patching and names will rarely be changed. You can start a new mix without needing to reset all those parameters. Otherwise, if you really want to start creating a new scene with a blank canvas, there are two options. Firstly, make sure you store a scene with all the default settings before you start programming. Or use the initialize function in the setup and maintenance menu. If you select the other option only, it will reset all current parameters without erasing any scenes or libraries, allowing you to start creating a completely fresh scene. If you wish to prevent any accidental change to a scene, use the Protect padlock. This will prevent any overwriting of the data that's in this scene, though it will remain available to be recalled at any time, and the locked status is clearly visible in the menu bar. Use it to protect your own starting scene or any others you don't want to be overwritten by mistake. Well, that has given you an introduction to the scene memory facilities within all Rivage PM systems. There is still a lot more to discover. Join me next time to learn about preview mode, overlay, and global paste. See you soon.